of that, innit? Yeah, mate, sick. Oh, you ready, yeah?
Yeah, we'll get out with you.
What's up?
Yeah, I'll do that.
Pump, oh, already.
It's cold, man.
Oh, yeah. Hey! Yeah, mate. Really coming. Going, Joey.
Yeah, mate, she's rolling.
Happy days.
Happy days, mate.
Nice one, Joe. Appreciate that, mate.
Deja vu. Guess who's back again?
The video camera snuck out.
Pondering his next move. Another blank night on the Thorpley. What are you thinking, Lou? What are you thinking?
I'm thinking, got to put on manly voice, sound like Joe Brazil and I. Go down 5 octaves. What I'm thinking is, you're my curse behind that camera. That's what I'm thinking. Full of love.
I've got a new nickname for you, Lou.
Go on.
52 Chuck Lou.
52 Chuck Lou?
Yeah.
Is that like Heinz 57, but without the heritage? Only two rods here. You can't hit.
So we're on the move now.
Yes.
Yeah.
Some fish showed down off an island down to the right earlier on. So, you ain't catching them in the last, what, 18 hours? Let's give it a few hours somewhere else, shall we?
Sounds like a plan, mate.
Better than sitting here and just admitting defeat. Fresh bites. And sit down next to Joe. Make him look like a mountain.
Come on in. You happy?
Oh, you always have to be happy when you've moved.
Yeah.
So all the gear's on the barrow. If he pans round, you'll see it, but it's only a wheelbarrow. There you go, it's a wheelbarrow. A few showed down here earlier, didn't they? So if I'm allowed to swear, because Steve, keep him in employment, keep him bleeping.
Go on.
It was up there, like.
Proper.
Should have been seeing loads, loads more. So.
Rods are rocking. Lou's feeling happy. Good one.
In the grey water, wouldn't it?
Just need
might
to see.
Might be my swim.
Might.
Might be.
Just need to start it, seeing a couple now that you've actually got the rods out there. No way. What you got?
Oh.
Has he got wings? He's not a duck this time. All right, better get some playing shots. Yeah. Right, I'm going to put this down.
There we go. 5 minutes in the right place, eh?
When in doubt, stick a yellow Ronnie out.
Does it feel like,
does
it feel like a weight has been lifted, Lou?
Sometimes, just sometimes, Joseph, the inferences of your commentary can be quite hurtful.
Does it feel like a weight has been lifted?
Yes, it has. A massive one. Because you always go to... What? How would someone like Oz say it? You go somewhere where you expect to catch and it feels a little bit easy. And when you come and you don't catch... Dear God, it makes me want to poke this needle in my eye. So, result, little one.
That'll do. It's a start, isn't it?
Worth the move.
Come on, Lou.
Learn that every single time.
Get that rod back out.
Always worth the move.
At least we've done it. We're going home, happy. We got the playing shot, sort of. That was my problem though. Not the best shots, but they'll do. So Lou's having another chuck in the hope that we may get one more opportunity. But if we don't, it doesn't matter. We've done it. Something is better than nothing. So, yeah. What?
Oh, it's just your way with word, Joseph. Something's better than nothing. Why not just say it as it is?
Like, what?
It wasn't the biggest or the prettiest. A bit like you.
No, it was all about my photos, mate, honestly.
Oh, your photo's always on point.
Mm.
That's what the girls in the nippers say, isn't it?
Yeah.
On point, mister.
On point.
So, no, thank for that. That's all I've got to say.
I know, isn't it? Lifting it right up.
Bloody hell, it's gone right out then.
So if you're wondering exactly where I am, you're right, I am no longer down at Thorpley. I'm in fact on the Linch Hill complex in Oxfordshire, more specifically Stone Acres. Quite a few lads fishing down here this sort of bank holiday weekend. And it is looking rather nice out there, a little bit cloudy, not as bright as it has been, but yeah, it's been really nice, quite warm. So, I'm down here with Ben. This is actually sort of a bit of a new adventure for Ben. Although he's fished on Linch Hill quite a bit, he's been, majority of that time has been spent on sort of Christchurch and Willow. So he's had quite a lot of fish out of both those lakes now, and sort of naturally the next stop for him is Stone Acres. So yeah, so that's the plan. Like I said, there's quite a few people down here fishing. A few of the lads down here, so I'm going to sort of float about for the next couple of days, sort of see what occurs, get this done with Ben, have some nice food, and yeah, just generally just hang about and annoy people, I think. But I'm pretty sure over the next sort of 24 hours, there's going to be something to report, if not from Stone Acres, then from Christchurch, because yeah, we've got a couple of lads down there as well. So yeah, I'm gonna float about a bit. I'm gonna watch Ben get his rods set and take some photos, and yeah, just like I said, just genuinely just float about and annoy people. But yeah, I'm sure I'll catch you in a bit. Old boys still been a going. Old Benny boys on it. What are you saying, Ben?
Keeping a keen eye over there, lad.
You happy with the rods?
Rods have been out sweet, mate.
It's been a few hours now.
Been a couple of hours now, mate.
A couple of hours. Wind's just dropped off, and there's signs again. So yeah.
Hopeful.
Ben's hopeful. If Ben's hopeful, I'm hopeful. Cupid. Well, that all went a bit crazy. Sat with Ben and pop this up here. Robbie called to say that he had caught. Oh, that's not going to do it, is it? So I'm just going to have to hold it like this. Yeah, caught Kev's linear at £49 an ounces. So yeah, just shot round here, filmed it on the proper camera. Got some mega steals, Robbie's happy, and yeah, it is now, what's the time saying? Yeah, it's now 10 to 8, so we are well and truly due food, so we're going to go get that on, and yeah, mega result for Robbie. Obviously, because I didn't get anything on here, like I said, we got a little bit on the proper camera, so hopefully Andy can put it up now, because I think everyone will agree that is what you call a carp. Well done, Robbie. Well done. Back to the swim, and we've had an intruder.
Hey, got me back for a testimonial, yeah? Testimonial appearance.
Show us them zigs there, Scott.
What do you mean?
Show us them zigs there, mate.
These are noodle kicker zigs.
Noodle kicker zigs.
I created these, by the way.
Scotty K.
Right, so I'm just going to fish out here to the left, Ben, yeah? Can you move your left hand
over? I won't have it, Ben.
He's asking me to move rods and that.
I won't have it, mate.
He's asking me to move rods.
I will not have it.
At least stretch my leaders out. Cut the kinks in them. Right, come on. So, I know everyone will be getting excited about seeing me back on the TA Raws and that, but sorry. You're going to have to, I'll tell you what, I'll be putting an invoice in for this.
It's only a cameo, it's only a cameo, isn't it?
Oh, here we go. Do you want to get the cam flick? Scope bag.
Prototype. Yeah.
Coming soon to tackle.
Bleep that out, Andy. Yeah, bleep that out. I'm turning it off now. What's happened here?
This is.
No.
This is sick.
What's happened here?
Not quite sure,
this
mate.
This is sick. That's brilliant. Mate.
It's not bad in that, is it?
That's a sick fish.
Do that.
That'll do, lad.
Do me, lad.
That'll do you. Damn right. It's a shot winner.
The Tesco's limp.
No way.
There you up. All right, Ben. Now get me waders on. I'll come and hold it if you want. Get ground for stabbing in it. Oh, you got him in?
That's mental.
First Stony Carl, no how you way. Feel, Ben? Happy days.
No way.
Good.
What we got? Oh, she's not quite a gatey, I'm not giving you. Oh, yeah, I am. Just over £30.2. Yeah, man.
Is it?
Sick. Yeah, just. Oh, wow.
Is it up?
Right, it's going.
Back end.
Is it up off the. Yeah, 30 and a half. 30 and a half, lad.
Let me just check this, mate.
Oh, I do know it, yeah.
Yeah, that's it, aren't we?
Well done, lad.
Go on, lads.
Come on.
Well done, buddy boy.
Nice one, mate. Come on there, Lynn.
Wait, what the release here, Benny? My man's walking to the island. Yes, lad. What are you saying?
Nice.
These were a bit fiery, these ones, though, you know.
Well, thank you, Dad.
Biggie Lid.
Cooking us up a celebratory feast, eh?
Trying to, mate.
I reckon. That. Oh, smell them already. I'm going to just put a couple of air in up here as well.
He's eight, isn't he? Biggie Lid.
That is excellent, that is.
It's just my testimonial on TA Raw, yeah. Eggs. Yep. Got a bit of waffle edge. Bit of blue waffle for you, Joe.
Blue waffle all the way, mate.
There you go.
Look at that. That is marvellous. You've done a good job of that, lad. I'll give you that.
I've got a picture of that.
One for the fighting machine.
Oh, like Sterling.
Watch it, it'll be warm, that will.
Smells delicious.
Look at that.
It smells absolutely
fiery waffles, boys.
Delightful.
I won't try and eat it yet, you know, boys. It's red as.
Give me that molten iron, that is.
Yeah, let it cool down. Otherwise, you're going to spool it.
Spoil it.
Spool it.
Spool.
Spool it.
Wow.
Yes.
Weekend, yeah.
Ooh. Right on me. Literally, mate.
Hopefully.
Head pump.
Oh, mate.
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Up a touch back, you go.
See shadows there somewhere, boys.
Shadow
there. Watch that shadow.
That's me.
That's me.
Yeah, well done, Scotty.
Cheers, mate.
Oh, mate. That is a serious carp, isn't it, mate? I think we would all agree that that was perfect timing for a little trip to Stone Acres. What a couple of days that was. Yeah, absolutely mega. The fish, the lads, just the general vibe. A really, really cool place. I don't think it's always like that in terms of action. I think it's pretty slow leading up to those couple of days. I think they'd done one bite through the week. So yeah, timed it impeccably. But yeah, now it is my turn. I'm down on Black Swan. It's been a couple of weeks, so yeah, itching to get out. And out we got. But yeah, I started off in another swim, sort of as close as I could get to where I'd been seeing them, but kept my eye on down here because as you can see, this wind has just been pumping down here all day. It sort of turned this morning, so yeah, sort of kept one eye on it, and sure enough, about half hour ago, saw a couple. So rods are out. I'm gonna get the bivvy set up, feed the dog, because it has been a long day, like I say. I've been keeping it on the barra for most of it. It's surprisingly busy, so it's actually Tuesday now, and yeah, it's quite shocked to see as many people as I have. So, but no, I'm not gonna complain. I'm on fish. Cuban. Good morning. Celebratory brewski. The best kind of brew. Good.
How's it gone off, mate?
Just turn it on and off again, mate. It's just a period of inactivity, I think.
You might have to prop these. A couple of these you'll have to prop.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah, that's fine.
That was going to be good then, as well.
It wouldn't have been if I dropped it. Mate, he's an angry one, wasn't he?
Well, that is the perfect start to a Wednesday morning. Probably got to take around about sort of, just gone free this morning, so quickly put them in the sack and got a hand with from the lads first thing to get it weighed up, get the photos done. I was going to go home today, but it seems mad to go home and sit in front of my laptop when I've got my laptop here with me, and there's fish still about, so I'm probably going to do that. I need to drag myself away from watching that, and I know they're here, so I can sit on my hands. I'm happy where I'm at. So yeah, just need to get my nose into my laptop now and take full advantage of it, because I don't think I'm going to get out next week. Filming actually 4 days next week, so probably going to be a bit much trying to squeeze a night's fishing in as well. So yeah, might as well make the most of it, make hay whilst the sun shines, as they say. But it looks absolutely mega out here. And like I say, I've seen them, so yeah, fingers crossed. May have another carp to report by the time the day's up, so that'd be lovely. But for now, time to get on with some work. So the breakfast may not be all that, but the view is lovely. Is there, fed, watered. Oh, what a lovely day at the office. Well, the day is slowly fading away. Still looks absolutely mega out there. So been seeing a couple of liners on the middle and the right hand rod. So I actually brought them a bit shorter. The liners have stopped, so yeah, you never know. There are other anglers. Andy's gone down in 12. It'd be interesting to see how that sort of affects it. I don't think it will. He's only fishing out short, so just need to keep my eyes on as that sun sets, because it was when they put on a little display last night. So hopefully much of the same. Like I say, it looks absolutely mega down here, so I'm still very happy with my choice. Probably just put that middle one back out to where I had the fish last night. They were showing short in here yesterday as well. I just think as it gets darker, I just think they tend to drop back in slightly into that ever so slightly deeper water, but which would make sense, as that's where I've been having my bites. Well, that's where I've had my two bites from in this room. So, yeah, managed to get a nice bit of work done. Cannot complain in the slightest. Tired eyes from staring at water, laptop, water, laptop, water. I can close them when it's dark. In fact, I probably won't. One of my favourite times to actually be having a little look, actually. Usually if you're on them when it's dark, it's good signs. Rods redone as they were yesterday. The only difference is I've adjusted the left and the right to the same depth as I had that fish on last night. So yeah, but that's it really. Can't really do much more. Replicated exactly as I did yesterday, fish are still present. Now it is in the hands of the carp gods, but I think you'll all agree. I know I keep saying it, but it does look bloody good. And I've still been seeing them, so yeah. Hopefully, we'll have another nice black swan carp to show you first thing in the morning, if not sooner. But yeah, till then, I'm gonna burn my eyes a little bit more and yeah, hopefully catch you at some point for the night or early doors. What happened, Luna? Where's the fish? Where's the fish? Damn you. Well. Nothing to report. Yeah, a little bit frustrating. It's funny because actually I got up this morning just before the sort of the sun was coming up and looks really quiet. To the point where I thought maybe they had done the off, but literally about an hour and a half of looking, nothing. And then I had a couple of bleeps on the middle rod and whoa, there goes another one. So yeah, they've just started to bounce out again, and that is not too far from my right hand rod. So yeah, definitely worth hanging out a bit longer. I'm not going to be able to stay all day, but I think I'm going to try and give it up to sort of half nine, 10 o'clock. And then yeah, then get out of here and get on with some work. But yeah, a little bit frustrating, a little bit annoying. Like I say, everything was as it was the previous night. So yeah, I don't know. Strange old carp, mate. These Dinton fish. Not normal. Well, that is that. As you can probably tell, I am now home. Need to really crack on and catch up with some admin work because yeah, I should have been doing that instead of sitting there getting mugged off watching them carp jump over me this morning, but it is what it is. It looks like a lovely day, so even if it's an evening in the garden doing bits on the laptop, there could be worse things to do. It's going to look pretty nice out there, so yeah, swings and roundabouts and all that. But I also need to make sure all my camera kit is where it's supposed to be, batteries fully charged, memory cards wiped, because we've got a 3-day shoot lined up with Oz. So yeah, that is going to be very, very interesting. I'm excited about that. It's going to be good giving you guys a glimpse, because there's actually going to be three of us on this shoot, so it's a bit of a bigger one than the one I did with Lewis. But yeah, so it should be fun. Should be plenty going on. So yeah, be cool to give you a little glimpse into all of that sort of stuff. And then yeah, there is a chance within the next sort of couple of days I could get called out prior to that, but I'm sure there's going to be a few lads out there fishing sort of back end of this week. But yeah, see what happens. But if not, the next time I see you will be on the banks of Junction 12 with Oz and Co. So yeah, in a bit.
As promised, on the banks of J12.
Oh, let me zoom out. Whoa. Nobody needs to see that first thing in the morning. But yeah, at Junction 12, as promised. Not going to hang around. I'll pick this up a bit later because Oz has actually seen a couple. So yeah, just need to crack on. Make a nice early start. You never know. Maybe even an early fish. So yeah, I'm going to put this down, get the proper camera out, and we'll catch up in a bit.
Poor Oz, look, eh? He wants to do is get his rods out.
Obviously, I am director. Call me Spielberg. Or Quentin Tarantino, actually. I prefer Quentin Tarantino, yeah. Call me Quentin. QT. Lance. Who do you think is a better director? Steven Spielberg or Quentin Tarantino?
Spielberg.
You want Spielberg? One for Spielberg. They're very different, aren't they?
To be honest, mate, I don't know who the other one is.
What, Quentin Tarantino?
What?
You don't know who Quentin Tarantino is? Pulp Fiction? What?
What the is that?
What?
I don't know.
Where have you been living, man?
In this country.
What? What? Honestly, Lance, Reservoir Dogs.
Oh, yeah, okay, I've seen that. Oh.
Jackie Brown?
No.
Hateful Eight? Django?
No.
Kill Bill?
Kill Bill.
Yeah.
Oh, there we go.
Tom Gibson hiding in the bushes again. Can barely see him there. Getting that close-up shot of Oz's stinky balls. Lad, fueling the troops with the fink food. What are we saying?
I ain't tasted it yet.
That's why. Oh. Mm. You're just being polite.
Well chefed up, Mr. Gibson. Very nice.
Batch cookies.
Hey, I'm not just saying it, but that is some banging bacon, isn't it?
It's cracking bacon.
That is some lush bacon.
No shrinkage.
Oh.
No shrinkage.
Proper
no
gear.
Water. Yeah. Well, you get bacon from wherever.
Right, you go
Asda or Morrison's. Yeah. It's just water. It's not boiling.
Spielberg or Quentin Tarantino?
Tarantino.
Yeah. All day long. Well, that didn't take long, did it? Happy days. Well, that turned into absolute carnage. Not one, but how many, Oz?
We got two!
Hey!
We're doing it.
Doing it! OG, mate, OG. Oz to the OG. Go on, show me that. So both of those, tea, coffee, in your cup. And yeah. I bet that cup goes in there, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Mate. Like a Russian doll.
Yeah.
Compact.
Oh, yeah.
Good morning. Wee. Vlogging kind of got put to one side yesterday. Obviously, it turned into a little bit of an afternoon carnage, and then myself and Lance ran to Sainsbury's to get a wok because Tom Gibson forgot it. And then, dinner around the GVs for the film. And then, then it was time for me to get my rods out. So, but back this morning, no carp. We woke up to a complete whiteout, but as you can see, that's started to clear now. It's actually looking quite nice. So I'm gonna put this thing back down, get back on the proper camera, and I'll catch you in a bit. It's Oz's morning update. I'm steaming up. Oh no, it's just the screen. But yeah, Oz's morning update. Looks like Tom's happy. Is Tom happy? Yeah, Tom's happy. Very rare is Tom happy. Oi, oi. One for the cameraman. Not a bad morning's work, that. Looks like the day continues in the same vein. I'm going to skip these ones in. I don't want to steal the bites from Oz. After all, it is him that's supposed to be catching them. But yeah, going to get this guy out, have a quick look. And yeah, get back down there.
Do nicely. Better crack on with some work though, eh?
Tommy G straight chefing again. What we got?
Oh. I'm swapping out the eggs though and doing bacon instead.
Oh, he's got to put bacon in with it as well. Good. Yes. Yes. Look at that. Good. Nom, 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 nom. What are those? What happened? Did you get your returner?
Just let it go. It's all right, we haven't done this much. We're used to this, aren't we, us?
Did he accidentally get away, mate?
Yeah. Escape artist, isn't it?
Spielberg or Quentin Tarantino?
Oh! Spielberg.
Ooh! Yeah. So that is two for two. Let's settle this debate by leaving in the comments who's the better director, Quentin Tarantino or Spielberg. It didn't actually help that Lance never had a clue who Quentin Tarantino was, so just went with the one that he knew. But let's settle it in the comments. Go on. Go on, Tarantino! Don't stop me now, I'm having such a good time, I'm having a ball. You want us eight? It's fair to say that this is shaping up to be quite the spring trip for old Ozzy. So yeah, something for you all to definitely look forward to. But we're going to get this fish out, process it, that's what we call filming a fish, called processing it. We're not about to kill it and turn it into sausages or anything like that. So yeah.
So, Ozzy's got the kettle on again.
Yeah, Ozzy's got the kettle on again.
Hey?
Don't want to give too much away from obviously what we've been filming in terms of like tactics and stuff like that, but there is a new product Oz has been using for this film. That's your cue, mate.
In true Blue Peter fashion.
What is it?
The one we got made earlier.
What is it, Oz?
This is a lead-free leader material, and a very nice one at that.
What's it called?
It is called something Fleck.
What's it called?
Flecky Fleck.
Flecky Fleck Fleck. Flecky it's Fleck. Called Sub Fleck. Thank you, Lance. And
Sub Fleck.
Despite I was using it for a year, mind you, it never had a name, did it?
No.
So, but yeah, and that is going to be out this summer. What do you like about it, Oz?
Supple, easy to splice, nice colourway, blends in with the bottom nicely. Yeah, and you can use it on some of those waters that have got the old lead core bands.
There you go. Get around those lead core bands. But yeah, that's going to be out this summer. So yeah, keep your eyes out for that one. Mmm. Oh, smells the bollocks. Smells spicy.
Mm.
Spicy, Tom?
No.
No?
I think it's spicy.
Spicy, Lance?
It looks it though, doesn't it?
Can't be spicy if you don't think it's spicy. You thought that ginger biscuit was spicy. Mmm. Oh, that filled a hole. That was very, very tasty. I'm not just saying it. I can hear you all out there now. Oh, I'm plugging it because I get it for free. We didn't actually get it for free. We paid for it. But that was beautiful. Definitely, definitely, definitely. If you're thinking about putting a think for food order in, I would definitely go for the fajita. Anyway, less of food. I'm back at my van.
slash swim.
Don't tell Tom Gibson.
Yeah, another great day. Oz has most certainly pulled this one out of the bag. I'm not sure if this is going to go out before. Quite possibly will go out before. So yeah, definitely something for you guys to look forward to. If it does go out afterwards, then yeah, let us know what you thought. I am going to have to tie up a fresh rig after my little bit of a morning action. Yeah, going to get them rebaited, get them out. Like I say, sun's gone down now, pretty much wrapped up for the day. What's the time? Yeah, 20 past 8, so yeah, no more filming, not until the morning. Hopefully Oz will have a whacker, or me. But just don't tell Tom Gibson. No carps, no carps. Nice and early, 5:30. Thought we were gonna get a nice sunrise, but then that cloud. It's getting quite dark. And it's, yeah. I reckon it might have done us. I'm gonna go down there anyway. Gotta have a brewski with us. See if he had anything for the night, which I don't think he has, because he would put it on the group. But yeah, in a bit. Right. If you watched the first one of these vlogs, you may remember me saying that it's gonna be a good way of keeping your finger on the pulse in terms of products, new products that are coming out. Already received loads of messages about this, but. Ooh, carp. Stinks of fish. That's what we like. So that is a product which is going to be coming out, and I'm sure a lot of you guys will be messaging when you see this video, asking when it is coming out. And if you want the honest answer to that, I can't tell you. We've had a couple of little changes made very recently, which obviously puts things back ever so slightly, but we're happy that those changes are going to make it pucker just how we want it to be. So so yeah, like all of our products, they go through a vigorous testing period, testing phase. We had several in, gave them out to the anglers, they gave us their feedback, and we've made the changes that that a few of the guys have requested. So yeah, it's meant that they're not going to be out now or even in the next sort of month or two, but they will be coming out, and when they do come out, we are very confident that everyone is going to like them. So yeah, so the retainer, retention sling, waist sling, ooby jooby, yeah, won't be out just yet, but something to look forward to. What have we got here then?
Can only mean one thing, mate. Morning beers.
Mate, what are you on about? Morning beers, even if you don't catch. Come on then. Let's do this, mate. Let's do this. So clear, mate, isn't it?
Nice, isn't it?
Mm.
Always check the pecs and fins.
Mmm.
Right, good to go, mate.
Chunk
Chunkosaurus, mate. Alright, I can barely see this where it's so bloody bright. I reckon. Yes, mate. She will do. You can't see it anyway. Right, hold him there.
Glare's not really, there's a little shine to her there, mate.
Try to tilt it.
That filter ain't doing a great deal.
No.
Not to that. It's, mate, it's...
What's the glare like?
Yeah, it's not too bad. There's a bit of a shine to him, but it's minimal again, mate. Quite like the marks of the like the water reflections. If that makes sense.
Cool cod. That's old. Just the man. So what was the weight again, mate?
41.8, mate.
41.8.
An up and coming cod in Rockford, mate.
Bleep that bit out, Andy.
Yeah, that's right, mate. Sicko one, eh?
Yeah, mate. Really, really cool.
Future giant, hopefully.
Die. See ya. Good.